Good afternoon. Thank you for all being here this afternoon. There's been a lot of interest in this issue and the city's issuance of permits to commercial cannabis businesses. I'd like to identify the city selection committee, although they're not in attendance at this time, but we expect them shortly. Megan Hunter, Matt Pressey, Andy Myrick, David McPherson, Matthew Eaton. My name is Courtney Grossman. I'm the planning manager for the city of Salinas. I'm here to facilitate this meeting. I'm not a part of the selection committee. So that everyone is aware, we have copies of the meeting agenda and a map. I think they're placed in two separate locations in the back of the room. They're 8.5-11 exhibits. The map shows the locations of the proposed cannabis businesses. There are 15 business operations which are proposed to be located in 9 different locations. Some of these businesses will be combined in the same location. These 15 businesses are the top in each of 3 categories: manufacturing, dispensaries, and cultivation. These 15 were identified through the first 3 phases of a 4-phase process. At this time, I'd like to hand over to David to explain a little bit more about where we are in this particular process.
So for those that haven't been following the process, we've actually created with the city staff a 4-phase process. They were scored separately and there was different segments of how it was done. So I want to just kind of share where the first 3 phases were done. So phase 1 was where it was looked at for some of the initial application information, which included background, which we're still in the process of due to delays from the life scans, and then the proposed location. That was really a qualifier or non-qualifier component of it. The applicants had to get a zoning verification letter to confirm that the location that they were using was sufficient and properly zoned. So again, that was just a qualifier or disqualifier. It had no scoring component. The second phase was a category of reviewing certain areas that we looked at, which had to do with the business plan, neighborhood compatibility plan, safety and security. And that was done independently from HDL companies and scored appropriately to that based on the information provided to us. The third phase was scored and looked and reviewed based on 14 questions that were asked to the applicants that covered community benefits, enhanced product safety, environmental benefits, labor and employment, local enterprise, and qualifications of the principals. And that was scored by the selection committee, which Courtney had just indicated were on the panel that scored them on a separate process. And that process was scored on 2,500 points and was 2/3 of the scoring component that weighed heavily on that aspect of it. So we are on phase 4, which is the public meeting and the selection committee's final recommendation that we are here today. And I'll pass it back to Courtney.
Thank you. The purpose of this meeting is to provide an opportunity for the property owners with property located within close proximity of proposed cannabis business locations to provide your feedback and input to the selection committee. And this is Megan Hunter, one of the members of the selection committee. Notices of this meeting were sent to all persons with property located within 500 feet of each of the proposed locations. This public meeting is an opportunity for the property owners to provide whatever input they may have regarding the proposed businesses. The selection committee will not be responding to your comments or responding to your questions at this time. This public meeting is your opportunity to speak to the committee and provide your thoughts, but we are not intending this to be a dialogue with the committee. The information we receive today will be used to develop conditions into the permits, which will be subsequently issued. We will use your information to address the permits concerns regarding the operation of the proposed location of these businesses. Each person will be allowed to speak for 2 minutes. We have allotted only 2 hours for this meeting, and it will end on time. I believe there's another meeting coming up right at 6 following this meeting. So please respect each other's time. The timeline for final decisions. The selection committee will meet following this public meeting and will identify the top 3 businesses in each category. This is expected in early May. The top 3 will be notified, and we anticipate the permits will be issued at the end of May. We've received 3 letters so far that I'm aware of. One letter from the Air Pollution Control District, another from John Bailey on Rianda Street, and a third letter, which escapes me at this point. It'll come to me in a second. From the school district. I think it was the Alisal Elementary, if I'm not mistaken. Thank you, Salinas City Elementary School District. Now is the opportunity for public comments. Each person who wants to speak will be given 2 minutes. No need to repeat comments that have already been provided. No rebuttals will be allowed, except for applicants will be allowed an opportunity to respond, but they'll still be subject to the 2-minute one-time rule. So be respectful of that. Each person may only speak once. So let's begin.
We also remind you, if you're talking about a specific location, make sure you identify specifically your concern of the specific location so we can take that in consideration of your comments.
And if there's a specific location, that entity may respond, correct?
After we're done with it, yeah.
And by the way, just to let folks know, this meeting is being recorded and it's also being broadcast live. So
come on up.
The podium is straightforward. I believe the mic is live, so please come forward. And Jordan will be operating the timer for the 2-minute rule.
We don't want toxins on Quail Run Circle. My name is Michael Corlett. I'm an owner of the first building constructed on Quail Run Circle. I strongly oppose cannabis oil extraction anywhere on Quail Run Circle. Why? No industrial business park in Salinas has our unique mix of attractive professional office buildings, mostly occupied by owner users. There are 8 parcels on Quail Run. In 2015, when we got word that Altai Brands was converting an existing office building to a manufacturing plant for cannabis edibles, we were all outraged. It was snuck through, and public officials were not truthful. In June 2015, KION had a story on the cannabis facility and read a statement issued by Altai Brands that stated, quote, "There will be no cannabis plant material on site. We only use cannabis in extract form as one of many ingredients." Councilman Steve McShane also appeared on camera and said, quote, "This operation is just another manufacturing business in the city of Salinas," end quote. Following week, 2 of us met with the city attorney. "No plant material is a bakery," he said. Based on these 3 parties making their representations, we, the owners on Quail Run Circle, chose not to, quote, go legal, end quote. Fast forward 22 months. Oil extraction is now part of manufacturing. Oil extraction means marijuana plants, thousands of them. In 3 of the 4 most popular extraction methods, that means the use of toxins, chemicals, etc. We oppose cannabis oil extraction on Quail Run Circle. If that means denying a manufacturing permit to an existing business, that's the way it goes.
Thank you, sir. Your time has expired.
No toxins on Quail Run Circle.
Good evening. Good afternoon. My name is Terry Ryan, and I'm the Director of Facilities and Safety at the Salinas City Elementary School District. Our superintendent is not able to attend tonight because she is out of town. You have a letter from her that was referred to earlier. As leaders in our education community, we are very concerned about the cannabis-related businesses, including grow ventures, production facilities, distribution operations, and retail sales in Salinas, and view it as a legitimate threat to our 9,000-plus students and their families. We believe that the potential designation of business zones and permitting of retail as well as production facilities require more study to ensure that our youth are protected. Our concerns include the runoff and contamination from production, what chemicals might be released into our atmosphere, stormwater, and into our rich soil. What potential risk is there in our kids gaining access to cannabis products that would be produced and distributed locally? Might an unsuspecting child find or be given a brownie or other food product? What potential risk is there for underage access to products sold at local retail shops? The myriad of byproducts such to be available pose a widespread danger to our youth. We firmly hold that no associated business should ever be considered for approval in any area near any school, and there are two of these facilities within a half mile of our schools. If any business is authorized to be established, it should only be after review of the most stringent security and safety considerations in order to protect our youth and our families. And it should be relegated to an area where their security and control can be vigilantly maintained. In closing, the Salinas City Elementary School District believes that it is premature to designate business areas or to approve any business until a much more thorough study is completed and vetted in the public venue. We educate our youth to compete in the 21st century, and we do not need any distractions that impede our mission or threaten the health of our youth and our community. Thank you.
Thank you for your comments.
Good afternoon. My name is Al Espindola. I'm a 50-plus year resident of Salinas. I've spoke to the council on this issue, and I would like to repeat, in your decisions that you make regarding cannabis and its dispensaries and all the other facilities, please give consideration to the local entrepreneurs that we have within our community. Thank you.
Thank you. No, there's, okay. If there are multiple folks, I would suggest perhaps a line.
Okay. Okay. I'm Michael Saloma. I'm a 25-year resident in the Laurelwood neighborhood. I also teach at Laurelwood Elementary School. My father died of cancer, and this is like 15 years ago, and he was a person that could have used medical marijuana, and I, you know, recommended that he do that. He chose not to, so I'm not opposed to medical marijuana at all. My concern is that the facility is so close to two schools. It's very close to the Laurelwood Elementary School and also close to Braun and Meadows School. I was out canvassing yesterday in the neighborhood and spoke to at least 20 parents that I knew, and each of these people all expressed a concern that a facility would be located so closely to the neighborhood. And we would prefer that a location would be more in an area that is not next to schools and young children. Okay, thank you.
Can you be specific about the address location you're referring to?
The Quail Run location over off of Rossi is very close to families that I know and have had your children. Like McAllister Street, I think, is the street that I'm thinking of. That's right directly across from it, I believe. But I spoke to parents all over the neighborhood who were concerned that the facility would be so close to our neighborhood and so close to our school. And that was a concern that I ran up against, and a personal concern that I have. I'll be leaving here soon, and I'm going to be going to a rehab center where my sister is currently staying to assist her. So I know this issue very well, and I know that marijuana is definitely an entry-level drug that takes you to other places if it's not used correctly. I also know from interacting with other young people that it's very easy to get around the system, and people that who actually don't really need medical marijuana have access to it, and I'm concerned about that as well.
Thank you. I believe you got the location, and your 2 minutes has gone.
Thank you.
Thank you.
Good evening. My name is Beatriz Diaz, and I am a resident of Greenfield. This is a last-minute thing, so I hope, you know, that I, you know, be able to say the right thing, because I'm nervous right now. I strongly, you know, would feel that you guys would take in consideration for the 514 Work Street and give them the opportunity also for the East of Eden and your Harkins Grow Guilty. I was one of the persons in our city of Greenfield that we're going to be having our green organics in Greenfield, and I really didn't want it, but now after education from hearing it, you know, I think it's a great idea that we do have it here. Thank you.
Thank you.
My name is Matthew Ancher, and I have lived in Salinas for the past 4 years and in the Monterey Bay area for the past 6 years. Before then, I grew up in North Carolina, and all I knew about Salinas before I moved here was what I learned when I watched The Grapes of Wrath on TV years ago. If you had told me then that I would be here now, I would have laughed at you. But just as the Jode family left the Dust Bowl behind, I made a move across the country, and since that time, I've started to see Salinas as my home. And in that time, I have used medicinal cannabis to help turn my life around. After having been diagnosed with autism at the age of 4 and having been subjected to an endless stream of prescription drugs by clueless educators, I have finally been able to turn my help around. It helps me regulate my mood better than any prescription drug and without the side effects. It also helped me regulate my appetite and helps with nausea. Recently, I came down with a bout of food poisoning, and I threw up there until nothing else was left in my stomach, and I couldn't keep anything else down. And once I was able to get to a dispensary, I felt better. And now that Proposition 64 has passed, I believe that the city has a lot of potential as a home for cannabis-related businesses, not just for dispensaries, but for farmers and the makers of cannabis foods and products. Unfortunately, I believe the city has taken more time than necessary approving the permit process. I want us to be ready when Proposition 64 actually takes effect. Too many storefronts in Salinas are just sitting empty and losing money for their owners. I would like to someday work at or even own one of those businesses, but they can't generate income and thus tax revenue until they're actually open. I hope that the city and the county can work with the cannabis industry instead of against it. In due time, this part of the state could become to weed what Napa Valley is to wine. But in order to do that, we have to make sure that we can create a climate that attracts businesses instead of pushing them out. We want to play by the rules, but that's hard to do when the rules are unclearly defined, inconsistently enforced, constantly changing, and with an unclear chain of command when figuring out who's enforcing these rules. My hope is that the city council will take steps to make it easier to open a cannabis-related business and for these businesses to comply with regulations. And where regulations are concerned, we should look at which ones we need and which ones we don't. Thank you.
Thank you.
Good afternoon. My name is James King, and I live at 501 miles from Quarrel Run, so I didn't get a letter at my house. I had someone knock on my door. I oppose these businesses in this town. I hope I don't get a stomach ache, but if I do, I know what my remedy would be, and it would not be marijuana.
Thank you.
Hi, I'm representing two buildings that are adjacent to two of your locations. One location on Market Street is adjacent to one of my properties. The other one is right next door, the one on Quail Run Circle. The one on Quail Run Circle, my concern is that we're in an industrial business park, but according to your zoning, there's no chemical manufacturing to take place. It's not permitted. And I view the extraction as a chemical process. So I don't think it should be there. The other one is on West Market Street, which that property is adjacent to residential housing. And I don't think that's a good thing to be putting next to residential housing. You're gonna have a dispensary and a grow next to residential housing, adjacent property to residential housing, which I don't think the neighborhood would really like. I, as a property owner, made sure that we didn't rent to anybody in the cannabis business because our property is adjacent to residential housing. And I don't think the city's considering that. Thank you.
Thank you.
Steve Stewart. I have the building across from 20 Quail Run Circle. I'm at 19 Quail Run Circle. I've invested my life in my business. I've invested my life in the city of Salinas. I think I have a good business. I've invested property and money into this location. Imagine having at your house a landfill put across the street with toxins and smells. What would happen to your property value? Would you be happy? I don't think so. I understand the issues of cannabis, but imagine the neighborhood, the children, the smells from toxic material that makes the oil. I don't think you guys have considered this, but imagine that, a landfill across the street from your home. Thank you.
Thank you.
Hi, I'm Steve Tibbs. I'm an owner and a partner in a building at 36 Quail Run, and I'm concerned with the 20 Quail Run property in regards to the manufacturing. A lot has already been said about the chemical use there. My other concerns in regards to it are the community that's within 250 feet. There is a State of California Department of Corrections facility just around the corner, 250 feet away. I spoke with those gentlemen. They're very concerned about a facility of that nature there with the plants and the extraction part of the business. I too have come to the conclusion that we're not going to stop them from making edibles and being a bakery, but I'm hoping that you can consider the chemical side of what they're doing with the extraction of the ethanol. My other concern is with the air pollution concerns. No one seemed to have addressed that with what they're doing there. The Monterey County Air Pollution Agency has no regulations. They're scrambling as well. So I'm hoping you can find it fit to find out what it will happen and what regulations will be set before that location is chosen based as the proximity to the neighborhoods. Also, I believe that this type of business should have some type of environmental impact study done, which I do not believe has been done. And that would be something that need to be completed in order to change that use from an IBP. Thank you.
Thank you.
Good afternoon. My name is Randy Rios. I own four properties here in Salinas. My primary residence is on National Court, and I'm here to speak to the property or the business proposed at 825 West Market Street. I came here originally to speak to the potential of the new criminal element, because National Court has seen some new criminal element in the last couple of weeks, which, you know, alarms us residents, as well as to address the letter written April 26th by John Bailey. I hadn't considered the chemical manufacturing at that facility and the potential for explosions as referenced in his letter, as well as the property values. Nowadays, when people with families, young kids, look for a neighborhood, they go to Megan's Law to see who lives in that neighborhood. This is also a potential negative for property values in that area. If people are going to look for who lives in the area, they're probably going to look for what businesses are in the area. And that's right behind a, you know, a thin wall, this business into the neighborhood. And I know I've spoke to four of my neighbors, and none of us are too excited about this. So please keep in mind, I do agree with the last speaker that maybe there is an EIR that should be done, since there is going to be chemical manufacturing, just to get more information. Thank you for your time.
Thank you for your comments.
Good afternoon. My name is Jim Gumberg. I'm one of the property owners at 2 and 4 Rossi Circle, which is one block over from the Quail Run project. Industrial business park designation light manufacturing is wholly inconsistent with the manufacture of an oil-based cannabis product. When we moved into our suite 11 years ago, we had to get a variance to allow a medical office as one of our tenants. Medical office, very concerned about the effect of their patients of having a oil processing business very, very close to our location. Across the street, there's a kidney dialysis center. I'm sure they'd share the same concerns. Thank you.
Thank you.
Good evening. My name is Patrick Orozco. I am the property owner at 20 Quail Run. Speaking to the issue of property values, we acquired the property only after the cannabis use was in place, fully licensed, and we had done some extraordinarily thorough vetting in order to determine the future of the industry as well as the legality of what was occurring there. We have subsequently endeavored to identify other similar properties that are specifically targeting cannabis use because of the improvement in value. It is a lesser understood tenant. It is a stable tenant. The manufacturing function is not public facing. The only business that is occurring there is essentially business to business. So there is 0% chance that anyone, any resident, any child, any member of the community, unless invited in, would have access to the facility. And I certainly understand and share everyone's concern for the sensitive nature of the industry. I do not, despite my long hair and beard, participate in cannabis use myself, but it's something that we've done a very thorough amount of research on, and we look at it not dissimilar from other activity in commercial real estate as a very viable use that contributes a great deal to the community. Thank you.
Thank you. Is there anybody else that would wish to speak?
Okay, as far as the odor, chemical pollution, and explosion concerns, there's four components to absolutely prevent all three of these things that need to be considered. Closed-loop ASME extraction system, a Class 1 Division 1 extraction enclosure, an industrial-grade recovery pump that is rated for continuous use and flammable gases, which is where most of these cannabis companies drop the ball. They use a pump that's rated for intermediate use and for refrigerants. That's why they have pump failure and leaks. And also train professionals to run the equipment, because you can have all the equipment and still mess up and do something wrong. So if you have all those, then you won't have to worry about the odor, the chemical pollution, or the explosions. Thank you.
Thank you.
Uh, Hi, I just wanted to talk about the facilities that would be at Quail Run and at Work Street. When this company that's purporting to work there, they're a parent company from Colorado called Dixie Elixir, who operates in California under LT Brands, and they've come here into your community and they've called themselves Cypress Manufacturing. But when they had their conference in November in Las Vegas to present themselves to the cannabis industry, I just want to explain to everyone in the community and here in Salinas how they chose to do that. They took a naked woman and they put her down on a platter and they covered her in preserved meat and raw meat. And the executives from the LT company ate off of this naked woman's body. And just feel like if you let this company come do business in your town, you're really saying something to the women of the community in Salinas. I also wanted to say that I went onto their website and I went to go, where could I buy the LT products? And right on their website, they have two places in Salinas that are listed there. So I'm just, you know, the city of Salinas has this thing called the municipal code, which are the rules and the regulations in the city of Salinas. And I'm a layperson, I'm not a lawyer. And when I read it, it said if you were going to operate in the city of Salinas, you were going to make sure that your medical cannabis wasn't going to be distributed to the wrong places. Well, right on their website, you can see that they're advertising right now, and I have that as an exhibit that I'd like to get into the record of a photo of their website that I took. It's right there that you can get their cannabis products here in Salinas. So I was like, wow, can you really do that? And I actually have two receipts in this bag of deliveries that I've had of their cannabis products while I've been in Salinas. And one of them, I was even sitting outside of their Work Street address at 641. So if they're manufacturing products now and they're not following the municipal code, how can we expect them to follow the municipal code for things like explosions? Those are things that really hurt people. So, yeah, just hope that if you let them in your community, you're ready to tell women that it's okay to be used as meat platters and for men to eat off of them. And I just also wanted to notice that the entire selection committee isn't here at 437, and that the HDL representative that was at the meetings for the participants or the applicants is also not at the meeting. Thank you.
Thank you for your comments.
Hi, my name is Armando Venegas. I have 160 acres in South Monterey County, and I'd like to find out, because I'm new to this, and I'd like to find out what permits and what where do I go to legally let people grow on my property, because I'm over like 2 miles away from my nearest neighbor, and even find like companies that want to go ahead and do the extracts, because I'm away from everyone, and if that's something the county is going to allow, I'd like to know how to get the permits for it and how to do things legally, because I'm all for it, and I think being away from everyone would probably help out a lot of different people. Thanks.
Thank you.
Yeah, just a point of clarification. This is the city of Salinas proposal, so I would encourage you to contact Monterey County.
Okay. Did you know when they're going to have like a meeting for Monterey County?
I don't know. I would just contact them. They have a public counter that's just down the street.
You can stop by my office later. Switching over here to City Hall, and I'll try to get in touch with my people.
Yeah, because it just sounds like with stuff being in town, it's kind of a concern for a lot of people. And if it's out in the country, away from everyone, it would help out a lot.
Any more public comments on the topic or specific sites?
Yes, it's regarding the Cypress manufacturing.
Hello, my name is Nicole Joel, and I'm a Salinas resident here. And I'm here to speak about the photo that was taken at a party sponsored by Alte during the Marijuana Business Conference in Vegas. And the Alte Brands is one of the most recognized names in cannabis edibles, I guess, available here in the Golden State. So they sponsored an event during the Marijuana Business Conference and Expo that was happening in Las Vegas. And a woman, as you know, in a bikini was hired to lay on a table with deli meat draped over her body. So I find it very degrading towards women and a very poor business choice on their part. And I don't think any person should be objectified in that way, or any way for that matter. But I don't think that this should portray or represent the cannabis industry. An industry, by the way, with an impressive amount of progressive female leadership. So, that's all I have to say about that.
Thank you.
Hello, my name is Edie Lerman. I'm an attorney and I work with Mike Hackett and Riverview Farms. I would like to thank the City of Salinas for all the effort that has been taken place, but I want to make sure that the city's aware of everything that is going on. And one of the items that concerns me most with this process has been the lack of ability to update information with respect to the plan. And so just recently I spoke with the city attorney who indicated that the appropriate time to turn over new documents would have been at the interview. However, at the interview stage, letters were sent out by HDL, the contractor, that said that no new information would be accepted. I was told by the city attorney that, in fact, several of the other groups had been provided an opportunity to provide new information. However, our group was never notified of this, and I think that the whole process should be transparent. So if one group is allowed to update, particularly because of such a lengthy delay, that should be true for everyone. Additionally, I want the city to be aware of the contract problems that exist. Is the city aware that Mr. McPherson was actually fired from Oakland, and that Oakland, the city of Oakland, I believe, is facing or faced a lawsuit because some of the software, albeit possibly some of the software that he is potentially offering for the city to use, I don't know, was potentially stolen from another organization or a private company. And so I don't know what efforts were taken to actually call the references, but I think it would be interesting to see what the city of Oakland had to say about that, given that they fired Mr. McPherson. In the contract that the city has with HDL, it doesn't prohibit Mr. McPherson from having a conflict. Thank you.
Thank you. Any more public comments on locations or the topic in general before we move on to applicant opportunities to respond? I see one more.
It would be helpful if you could line up so we can get a sense of how many more comments we are taking from the general public.
Hi, my name is Tor Roberts. I'm the president of SSCS. We're a software development company. We're located at 650 Work Street. I don't care what people put in their body. That's their problem. What I care about is any business that can affect my business. And so I'd like to know, obviously, like everyone else, the safety involved in these facilities, and also how it'll affect my employees and attracting employees. We have a hard enough time getting qualified, software developers in the Salinas area. And I'd like to know, the impact on that. So I hope the city does a good job investigating this. And also, being illegal federally, what happens a couple years down the road when the feds come in and confiscate all this property? I'd be concerned about that. Also, the letter that we received, it says the city want to adopt an ordinance as a way to accommodate the needs of medically ill persons in need of marijuana for medical purposes. I'm not a doctor, but I can't imagine it requires this many facilities to accommodate the needs of the medical marijuana users. So it seems to me it's sort of a dishonest on the part of the city. So thank you.
Thank you.
Hi,
I just have two concerns. The first is two of your applicants, it seems, that have had ethic issues, one concerning some serious limitations as Cyprus. And I was just wondering, also another applicant, an ex-city manager, that is, it seems to be on the board of members of the cannabis company. So my concern is there any precautions taken to allow these businessmen to do business here in Salinas? Because I think it would be correct to have some kind of a continuous background check and see if anyone of the applicants has any ethic or any legal problems before any license is granted. Thank you.
Thank you. Looking around the room, I don't see anybody else moving forward on the public comment section. Going once, going twice. Okay, this concludes the public comment section. What I'd like to move on to is agenda item number 5. This is the applicant opportunities to respond section. Applicants who would like to provide additional information for the public to consider will be given the opportunity to do so now. This is not intended to be a full review of your application or your proposed business operation. This is intended to give you an opportunity to clarify any misunderstandings which you may have heard this afternoon, or to respond to any issues which may have been raised this afternoon. Again, you'll be limited to 2 minutes.
Good evening, committee. It only seems right that I should go first. Robert Weekly, co-founder and president of Indus Holdings and 20 Quail Run. You know, one of the greatest compliments we always have there is people tell us all the time, we didn't even know you were there. We've been operating there now for 2.5 years. We did a city call log and have had only 3 calls ever, and it was actually 2 for a false alarm on our security system and 1 for a letter that was being served. So, we have been a big part of this community, I think, for 2.5 years. I've heard the comment about a parent company in Colorado. We are not. We are locals. I've lived here for over 15 years, raised my family here, and continue to contribute to the city. Sit on the executive board of Boys and Girls Club and do a lot of things here. So again, when it comes down to, I did hear the comment on Vegas. Me as a father of 3 daughters, I, as a CEO of the company, actually personally apologize for decisions that were made in Vegas, but do not represent our company in any way, in the way that we make decisions and the way we represent the city of Salinas. So again, thank you for your efforts and your process, and again, look forward to working with all the other great people in this room to make Salinas the leader when it comes to regulatory cannabis use. Thanks.
Thank you. Any other rebuttals from applicants? I think I see one.
Good afternoon. I'm Ricky Cabrera, one of the persons applying for a permit. And in response to one of the comments as to how the process has worked, I do want to congratulate the city. They have done, in my opinion, an excellent job in running the process and investigating, regardless of whether I get a permit or not. I
tip my hat off to you, all you guys. Thank you. In response to another comment regarding that we're backed up into residential housing, we are not. There's also a body shop, liquor store, cooling plants. The body shop will emit far a stronger smell than would we would actually we would not emit any smell, period, with carbon filters. And in regarding the criminal element, this is medicinal cannabis, medicinal. I have had several discussions with retired Chief Kelly McMillan in him being in charge of security during the hours of operation. That's how serious and committed we are to making sure this is an efficient operation. And regarding the second comment about having chemical manufacturing, we didn't apply for chemical manufacturing. That's not us. And that's pretty much it. Thank you.
Thank you. Last chance for rebuttals. Hearing none, seeing none. I'd like to move on to agenda item number 6. This is comments from the selection committee. And this concludes the public comments and the applicant comments. Members of the selection committee may now choose to provide additional information about the process, the next steps, and the timing. As I mentioned earlier, the selection committee will not respond to comments or questions made today. But at this point, I'd like to hand off to David for some more summary and next steps.
Appreciate that, Courtney. Some of the comments made today were legitimate concerns, and I encourage you, if you have not read the city regulatory ordinance, a lot of those things are going to put very robust requirements that you've addressed in all those certain functionalities, from odor mitigation to security to sensitive use areas, oversight and management of the process. The state as well has some requirements in there that are going to be a part of that, especially on the manufacturing side and some of the requirements addressing that. So again, there's going to be some good accountability and oversight in this process on there. But there was also some good comments made that I think were taken as submission as part of additional requirements that may be more specific or detailed in the permit requirements as we go through them. Thank you.
Any other comments from the committee?
I think I would just like to reiterate, you know, because there were some concerns brought up about, you know, whether or not we're taking a look at, you know, potential impacts of these
particular businesses. And I'll say I've been with the city for about 13 years now, and this is by far the most rigorous, intrusive permitting process that I have ever seen. We have asked questions of these people. We have made them show us documentation that we have never even come close to requiring from any other type of business here in the city. So, and it includes all the things that have been brought up: security, air pollution, odors, crime. All of that has been taken into account and are reflected in the scores that were presented earlier. So, I just want you to know that we are taking our responsibility very seriously here, that we want to make sure that we're able to adapt to the times that are changing while at the same time preserving the positive things that we have here in our community. And, you know, if you think of something walking out of this, if you'd like to provide any last comments you didn't think of, write them down, type them up, and submit them to the city attorney's office here at the city, which is over here in City Hall. Thanks.
Thank you, Mr. Myrick. So I'd like to conclude this meeting with a couple of comments. One, thank you for your time for coming down here and participating in this process. And as previously mentioned, Decisions will be made on these applications in the next 30 days. We expect an end of May. And this concludes this meeting. Thank you.